How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and it's time for another super quick and straightforward static review. And this one, folks, is a Dapol N-scale Mark III HST passenger car in the GWR livery. This one is the first class version, folks. So details are as follows. Still got the original tissue wrap, as that's how it was when it came to me when I bought it new. Well, I had to import this one from Germany. Reference number is 2P-005-323. Mark III GWR Green, first class, numbered as 41149 HST. And it's just identical to the TSO. The only difference is it has a slightly different interior and, of course, the first class markings. So, okay, just going to have to zoom out a wee bit just to bring that out of the box. Still got the tissue wrap on this one. And this one is going to be a super quick, straightforward review. We have got the inlay plastic as well. Not sure why Dapol include them, to be honest with you, folks, as they just fall out and they tend to be a pain. We've got some accessories there, folks, like the brake discs and stuff, which you can glue these on if you want to. And if we just take the model out, metal wheels all round, very much basic detailing underneath. So just to show these, we have got NEM couplers, so that's grand. And full flush glazing all round, so that's another grand feature about these models. They're all full flush glazing, so they're quite realistic. They're not too expensive. These range from about £30 to about £45 now, as you can only buy these pre-owned, unless Dapol have plans to do any more batches of these, of which at the time this review was done, that wasn't the case. So it depends on what livery you want as to the prices you'll pay for these, but this is a GWR one, and prices can vary considerably. So that, folks, concludes the introduction. I'm just making sure that's not going to roll off before we close off the introduction bit. So next up is the close-ups and then the full rotation, and that will be very much it for this short review. Okay, folks, this is the close-ups, and as you can see straight away, the only notable difference is that we do have the first class green bands on the saloon doors, and we just have a number one also nearest to the doors as well. There isn't really much notable difference, and we do have a yellow band above the saloon windows, so it's not much to really see on the model in terms of external view, although the seat information on this is 2x1 as per the real things, and there is the option for adding a light bar into these Mark III coaches by Dapol if you want to. These are N-scale, folks, so without further ado, let's just get on with it then, and let's unlock the tripod and get straight into the action. What you'll see here, folks, we do have full flush glazing all round, including on the end vestibule doors, and we do have catenary warning signs and the red band, also known as the cant rail. So all in all, very nice model. There isn't really much difference between this and the TSO that I covered in the last review, so this one's going to be made short and sweet, folks, so just to avoid repeating myself too much. But that, my friends, concludes the close-ups. So it's now time to move on straight into the full rotation, and that will be up next. Okay, folks, let's zoom out and let's do a full rotation. So without further ado, we will go clockwise. I have derailed this carriage just to stop it from rolling off the turntable and potentially go crashing on the floor, as I don't want that, certainly not in my reviews. And as you can see there, folks, detail is repeated on the other side as well, so it's a very nice model in my opinion. And to be honest, I do recommend them if you have HSTs in N-scale from Dapol, and I may cover one in the future in another another livery, I don't know, but I'm very much more into American model trains now, so they're more of my thing, as my interests in that have changed. And as I did mention back in a previous review, I'm more interested in the Tier 4 Gevos, even more so than the Class 60s. So that may be a surprise to some of you that have known me for a long time, but the GE Tier 4 Gevo is my all-time favourite locomotive. So I have a new favourite now. But anyway, folks, that concludes the full rotation in this review. I'm going to round this one off with an 8 out of 10, just like with the last review. So an 8 out of 10 is a fair and a justified score. And that, my friends, concludes this review. Thank you for watching. All the best. God bless. And I will see you in the next one. The best of 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 the best of